Well, hello there. Welcome, Huggabear friends. Would you like to join us on Huggabear Farm for some adventure, music, imagination, and fun? Oh, you would? Wonderful. Well, then climb on up, because this here's the Huggabear Express.
All aboard!
Today, we have a great show planned all about rainbows, promises, and pumpkins. I was just about to go check the Huggabear mailbox. Come on, let's go. Look, it's a postcard from God, and it's to you, our Huggabear friends. Let's see what the good word of God says today.
God said to Noah, I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Genesis 9:13.
That is a good word of God, and it's perfect for our show today. Come on, let's go see what else is happening on Huggabear Farm.
We had so much fun building our new Huggabear Farm. It's a lot of hard work, but it's very rewarding. Josh does the building, I do the painting, and together, Josh and Samuel constructed the new Bearford Falls town at Huggabear Farm. I think we make a pretty good team. But we always make the time to stop and enjoy the magnificent art that our God creates all around us. And there's been a couple of times that God has blessed us by placing rainbows in the sky over Huggabear Farm. When Samuel was 5, Josh built him this special fire truck bed. Now, it's been refurbished to use on Huggabear Farm for children to enjoy. The Lost Dutch Bear's mine got some new additions. And the mine donkeys got some touch-up too. We got the Huggabear Library all shined up and spiffy, and it is happily serving the children of our neighborhood. And we helped the Bearwood Forest Berry Fairies get comfy, cozy, and all settled down in our front yard. We still have plans for more family fun additions to Huggabear Farm, but on Saturday, October 29th, 2022, we were happy to open our doors and welcome children to come and play on everything we had completed on Huggabear Farm for our annual pumpkin party. Here are some pictures from our pumpkin party. Our pumpkin party was a blast. We had so much fun. There were so many fun things to do. Children love to pan for gold in the Lost Dutch Bear's mine. They got their faces painted. They decorated pumpkins that they got to take home. They enjoyed playing in the fire truck. They got to be cowboys and cowgirls and rope a purple cow. They jumped on the trampoline, did some trick-or-treating, and every child got to take home a Huggabear. Playing games with Mr. Josh was pretty fun, too. The kids also enjoyed exploring the fairy village. The weather was lovely. It was a bright, sunshiny, cool autumn day, and it was a perfect time for children to come and play and use their imagination. But the best thing was letting every child there know that Jesus loves them. Samuel still loves his old fire truck. We were so thankful to everyone who came to celebrate the grand opening of our new Huggabear Farm with us. It was a wonderful time. Thank you, God, for such a beautiful day to share the love of Jesus with others.
Hugga, 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 hugga bears, hugga, hugga bears, hugga, hugga bears.
We sing, dance, and play. We love and dream and share. And we are thankful every day that we are Huggabears. We are Huggabears.
Huggabears, hugga, Huggabears. It's time for story time with Huggabears.
Yeah. Tanushka, what do you have?
A flower!
You brought me a flower? Thank you so much, you sweet little bear. You look so handsome in your bow tie. And you little fairy cubs, oh my goodness, you look beautiful in your dresses. I love them.
Thank you. We like your dress.
Oh, you like my dress? Thank you. This was made by my designer, Aven Saleh, because she knows that I like to use my imagination and sometimes play like I'm a fairy. Because it's fun, isn't it?
She sounds amazing.
She is amazing. Huggabears, look who's here. It's our Huggabear friends.
Hi, Huggabear friends.
Guess what time it is?
Story time.
That's right, it's story time. And today we are going to finish tale number 5, Promises of the Forest Berry Fairies, and see what happens. Are you excited to hear the end of the story?
Yeah.
Yes. Are Huggabear friends excited to hear the end of the story? I hope so. Are you ready? Okay, here we go.
The little fairy bears worked and played and played and worked a little more until suddenly Shaylee said, "I'm hungry." "I am too," said Dolcina. "Yes, my tummy is beginning to growl," Tippy agreed. "I want to eat some berries so much." Shaylee pondered for a moment. "If we ate any berries, we would not be keeping our word, and that would break our promise to Mommy and Daddy," she said softly. "Yes, that's right," Tippy agreed. "Even if no one else found out, we would know we broke our promise, and so would Jesus." "I don't want to break my promise. I want to keep my word," Shaylee said. "Me too. I want God and others to trust me," Dolcina agreed. Suddenly, they heard the voice of Daddy Bear calling, "Come on, everyone. Lunch is ready." Hooray! We're saved! Kushla cheered. We can keep our promise, Dolcina said. And we can eat, Sabu added. When they arrived, Mommy Bear had a lovely picnic lunch all spread out for the family to eat. She had prepared a splendid Forest Berry Picking Day feast. There was ice-cold Forest Berry juice to refresh everyone from their hard day's work. Then, for lunch, she had made cornflake-crusted chicken stuffed with fresh spinach leaves, tossed green salad, roasted corn on the cob, cheesy scalloped potatoes, and warm buttery rolls, with Mommy Bear's jam, of course. Everything looked so wonderful and smelled oh so good. The family sat down to eat, and Kushla and Sabu prayed over the food. Thank you, Lord, for our food, and bless it to our bodies. Amen. Praise Jesus, the cubs praised, waving their little paws in the air. As they ate, Kushla, Sabu, and Rosalie told Meemaw's story about the Bearwood Forest Berry Fairies and of their adventure imagining that they were little fairy bears. I am so proud of you all, Mommy Bear delighted. You worked hard, had fun, and kept your promise, she smiled at the cubs. That's right, even though we were really hungry, Sabu began. And these berries looked oh so sweet and juicy. We didn't eat even one berry, Kushla finished with a big smile. That's wonderful. And now we all know that we can trust you to help with berry picking, Daddy Bear said proudly. Yes, you can. Look, Sabu exclaimed as she held up her basket full of berries for everyone to see. This year, the berries will make it into the jam, and not just into our tummies, she giggled. Everyone laughed and cheered for the little cubs. You all did great and worked very hard, Daddy Bear said. But more importantly, you kept your promise and proved you can be trusted. That's right, Mommy Bear began. Not only is it important for others to know that they can trust you, but it's also important to God. The Bible tells us in Proverbs 12:22, God does not like lying lips, but he delights in those who are trustworthy. Keeping your promises is very important to God because he always keeps his promises to us, Mommy Bear explained. We must remember that whenever we make a promise to someone else, God sees and hears us. That is why we need to honor all our promises so that we please God and represent him well to others, Daddy Bear said. Yes, Meemaw began. Do you remember what God's promise was to Noah after the great flood? I know, Sabu said. He promised Noah that he would never flood the whole earth again. That's right, Meemaw Bear answered. And do you remember what the sign of his promise was? I do, Kushla squealed. He painted a rainbow in the sky. Very good, Mommy Bear said. The Bible tells us in Genesis 9:13, I have set my rainbow in the clouds, and it will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Whenever I bring clouds over the earth and the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will remember my covenant between me and you and all living creatures of every kind. Never again will the waters become a flood to destroy all life. What is a covenant? Rosalie asked. A covenant is a promise from God to us, Daddy Bear answered. Now, there are those in the world who don't know or have forgotten the real meaning of the rainbow. But you must never forget it. The rainbow, with its seven beautiful colors, is created by God, and it belongs to God. It is a symbol of God's promise to us, Mommy Bear said. Yes, Daddy Bear added. It is also a reminder that God always keeps his promises to us, so we need to keep our promises to God and to others. Mommy Bear smiled. So when we see a rainbow, we will always know God keeps his promise too, she sang to the little cubs. Do you understand, little ones? The sweet little cubs all nodded their fuzzy little heads.
Oh my goodness, Kushla exclaimed. Look at Tanook!
Everyone looked over at the baby cub, who was head first inside Cebu's basket of forest berries. The family began to laugh at the baby cub.
Well, he didn't make a promise not to eat the berries, Cebu giggled. I guess I'd better go back out there and pick some more.
We will come with you, Kushla said.
We can pretend we are forest berry fairy bears again, Rosalie delighted.
All right then. Come on, Shaylee. Come on, Dulcina, Cebu cheered.
Okay, Tippy, let's fly,
Kushla shouted, jumping into the air. Mommy and Daddy Huggabear and the rest of the family laughed and enjoyed watching the little cubs use their beautiful and creative imaginations to become Bearwood Forest Berry Fairies and pretend to fly away. They took in every moment, for they know that little ones only stay little for a little while. The end.
Oh, I loved that. Did you enjoy hearing the rest of that story?
Yeah!
I hope our Huggabear friends enjoyed hearing that story too. Kushla and Cebu, was it fun for you to use your imagination and pretend like you were fairies flying around the forest?
Yeah!
Yes! And Tanushka, we got to see how much you love to eat forest berries.
Yummy!
Yes. Now, if you would like to have a free ebook of this story, all you have to do is email us at huggabearfriends@gmail.com and we will send you a free ebook of this story so you can read it at home. Now, Mommy and Daddy Huggabear had a nice lesson about God's rainbow in this story, but I have some more information that I would like to teach you all about God's rainbow. And so we're going to have that lesson now. Okay? So let's say goodbye, Huggabear friends.
Bye.
Until next time. Bye, Huggabear friends.
Have you ever seen a rainbow in the sky? I love seeing rainbows in the sky, which isn't too often because I live in a desert and it doesn't rain very often here. So every time I see a rainbow in the sky, I make the time to stop and look at it and enjoy it because I know that a rainbow is a symbol of God's covenant between Noah and all of us that he would never flood the earth again. Do you know what a covenant is? A covenant is a promise between God and us, all of his children. And he makes these promises in his word, the Bible, which is holy. God never breaks his promises because God never goes against his word, not ever. Do you know the story of Noah and the ark and the promise in God's rainbow? It is found in the Holy Bible, in the book of Genesis, and it starts in chapter 6 and it goes through 7, 8, and 9. I am going to read some of that story to you now.
Here is the history of Noah. In his generation, Noah was a man righteous and wholehearted. Noah walked with God.
Noah fathered three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth.
God, Adonai, saw that the people on earth were very wicked, that all the imaginings of their heart were always of evil only, and it grieved his heart. God said to Noah, "The end of all living beings has come before me, for because of them, the earth is filled with violence." make yourself an ark of gopher wood. You are to make the ark with rooms and cover it with pitch, both outside and inside. Here is how you are to build it. The length of the ark is to be 450 feet, its width 75 feet, and its height 45 feet. From everything living, from each kind of living being, you are to bring two into the ark to keep them alive with you. They are to be male and female, of each kind of bird, each kind of livestock, and each kind of animal creeping on the ground. Two are to come to you so they can be kept alive. This is what Noah did. He did all that God ordered him to do.
Then the waters flooded the earth.
All the fountains of the great deep were broken up, and the windows of the sky were opened. It rained on the earth 40 days and 40 nights. The water grew higher and floated the ark so that it was lifted up off the earth. God remembered Noah, every living thing, and all the livestock with him in the ark. So God caused a wind to pass over the earth, and the water began to go down. By the first day of the first month of the 601st year, the water had dried up off the earth. So Noah removed the covering of the ark and looked, and yes, the surface of the ground was dry. God said to Noah, "Go out from the ark." So Noah went out with his sons, his wife, and his sons' wives, every animal, every creeping thing, and every bird, whatever moves on the earth, according to their families, went out of the ark. God spoke to Noah and his sons with him. He said, "I will establish my covenant with you, so that never again will all living things be destroyed by the waters of a flood, and there will never again be a flood to destroy the earth." God added, "Here is the sign of the covenant I am making between myself and you and every living creature with you for all generations to come. I am putting my rainbow in the cloud. It will be there as a sign of the covenant between myself and the earth." God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant which I have established between myself and every living creature on the earth." Isn't that an amazing story? God told Noah, "I will place my rainbow in the sky as a sign of my covenant with you." So because God created the rainbow belongs to God. Did you know that there are 7 beautiful colors in God's rainbow? The number 7 is a special number to God because it represents completion. That is why God's rainbow has 7 colors in it. Some people like to use the name Roy G. Biv to remember the colors of God's rainbow. Let's count them together. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. There are some people who create rainbows with the color of purple instead of indigo, and they use the color pink instead of violet. But what is important to remember is that when a rainbow has 7 colors in it, that is a rainbow of God. And the rainbow of God is a symbol to all of us that God promises to never flood the earth again. Whenever I see a rainbow, I'm also reminded that God always keeps all of his promises to us that he has made in his holy word. We have a special song about that. Part of the song is called "Can You Sing a Rainbow?" written many years ago by a man named Arthur Hamilton. In Arthur's song, he uses the word pink instead of violet, and he uses purple instead of indigo. The other part of the song is something that God gave to me.
to teach all of our Huggabear friends how God is the one that created the rainbow and that he placed it in the sky as a symbol of his promise between Noah and all of us that he would never flood the earth again. And when we see a rainbow, we can also know that God keeps all of his promises too. MaCaedyn and I got our Huggabear friends Ashlyn and Kinsley to help us sing this song. We're going to sing it for you now, and we hope that you will sing along with us.
Today, I'm going to take you on a tour of the new Bearwood Forest Berry Fairy Village on Huggabear Farm. Keep a close eye out for some fairies that you may see along the way. Come on, let's go. Thank you. Thank you so much for letting me show you the new Bearwood Forest Berry Fairy Village. I hope you enjoyed watching berries with me. Now let's go see what else is happening on Huggabear Farm.
Hello, Huggabear friends, and welcome to the Rad and Glad Scientist Lab. I'm Hydro, the Glad Scientist, and I'm so happy to be here.
And I'm Radon, the Rad Scientist. Today we're going over an experiment called Rainbow Milk, so we can learn all about molecules and find a bond with each other. That's totally rad.
You may be asking, what is a molecule? A molecule is two or more atoms joined or bonded together.
Now you may be asking, what is an atom? Well, I'll tell you, Huggabear dudes, an atom is the smallest building block of matter. They make up the things all around us. That's why you can never trust an atom, because they make up everything.
Yeah, they're so great. I love atoms and molecules. Now, in this experiment, we'll get to see molecules bonding with the fat molecules in milk.
For this experiment, you will need pie. Oh no, wait, a pie tin. Some milk, liquid food coloring, some dishwashing liquid, and a Q-tip.
I love Q-tips. Today we have some special helpers, our Huggabear friends, Kensley and Ronan. I'm so glad to have you guys here.
To begin this experiment, we fill the pie tin with whole milk.
After you pour the milk, add some drops of different colors of food coloring all around the pie tin.
Now, take a Q-tip and dip it in the dish soap, and then put it in the middle of the milk.
You won't have to stir the milk. Just place the Q-tip directly into the milk and watch the rainbow fun begin. When you see the food colors mixing up, that is showing you how the dish soap molecules are attracted to the milk molecules, and they are racing around trying to bond with the milk molecules.
It's like the molecules are moving around so fast, they're about to explode. That's totally rad. As the dish soap molecules bond with the milk molecules, the colors will slowly stop moving.
This experiment is an example of a reaction that can take place when molecules bond.
Whoa, that was totally rad.
That was awesome. What did you guys think of it?
That was cool.
We want to thank our Huggabear friends, Ronan and Kinsley, for helping us today. I'm so glad to have you guys with us.
Yeah, and thanks for helping us today in the Glad and Rad Science Lab.
That's totally rad.
That's all for our rainbow milk experiment in the lab today. I loved it. Made me so glad.
Yeah, man. It was totally rad.
Bye, Huggabear friends.
Thank you.
Aven Saleh loves cosplay and making gowns and dresses. She has an Etsy store called Tiaras and Pumpkins and Things. And today, we're going to learn how she made a rainbow space dress. She started by folding her large piece of fabric for the dress into sections and then dyeing it in different colors to form what is called an ombre, a blending of different colors to give it a rainbow effect. This fabric swatch demonstrates what the dress will look like after it is dyed. The dyeing process takes time and must be repeated over and over until Aven gets the colors just the way she wants them. Aven makes her own patterns and will often use draping techniques before she cuts the fabric just to make sure the dress will look and lay exactly the way she wants it. After some pinning and some sewing on her sewing machine, the dress begins to take shape. And Aven adds the trimming. Aven had accessories for the dress 3D printed, and then she painted and decorated them for the dress too. Then, after several hours of hard work, the rainbow space dress was finished, and it was beautiful. Aven entered the dress into the Arizona State Fair fashion show. Aven's friend, Savannah Bakarich, modeled the dress in the fashion show, and she looked lovely. Aven won first place for the rainbow space dress and second place for another space costume that she made, which was modeled by her lovely friend, Shelby Abink. Congratulations, Aven! That's all for this show. Be sure to tune in next time, Huggabear friends, to see what Aven creates on
Aven Makes a Dress!
Welcome back, sir. It's good to have you.
Oh, I thank you, Buxley. It's good to be home.
Will you be needing anything else tonight?
No, I think I'm probably going to take a shower and head to bed. I'm rather quite tired.
Very well, sir.
Thank you.
Pardon me, sir.
I'm sorry, sir. I was just wondering if you wanted me to hang your vest.
No, thank you, Buxley. I think I can manage myself.
I'm so sorry, sir.
Oh, well, it's quite all right, Buxley. You just gave me a little bit of a fright.
I think I'll have my shower now, Buxley. Thank you.
Very good, sir.
Pardon me, sir. I'm very sorry, sir. I just wanted to know if you wanted a cup of warm milk.
No, thank you, Buxley. That will be all.
Well, Huggabear friends, that's all the show that we have prepared for you today. We hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. And we hope that you will come back and visit us again very soon, because we love to spend time with Huggabear friends just like you. And finally, all of you live in harmony with one another. Be sympathetic, love each other, be compassionate and humble, do not repay evil with evil, or harsh words with harsh words, but with kindness, because to this you were called so that you may. Remember, Jesus loves you. And so do we. See you soon.
I feel like Steve from Blue's Clues, you know, it's like, we just got a letter, wonder who it's from, God.
Welcome home, sir.
Thank you, Buxley. Have you back. Thank you, Buxley.
I forgot my line. Is there anything else I can do?
Okay, that's as tall as you'll go there. Just a little bit. There. And let's adjust this one.
Thank you so much for letting me share with you the new Forest Berry Fairy Village. And that's it.
And action.
Hold on.
One, two.
Why does she look so red?
What?
She's sunburned.
You look super pink.
You are pink.
Totally red.
I love atoms and molecules. In this experiment, no.
We have a chicken down. I repeat, a chicken is down. And action.
I'm laughing at the camera. I forgot. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
There's
wait, hang on. Just keep it rolling. Keep it rolling.
I love Adam.
Keep it rolling. Okay. Yeah, I love. No, 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 no. That's all for our rainbow milk experiment in the lab today. That's it for our rainbow.
Solo part. And then I'm going to position you on the stool where you're going like this. And action. All right. And action again.
Bum, 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 bum.
You doing that and looking at the camera so that I can try to have you guys sliding down rainbows in the video, okay?
Welcome back, sir. One thing.
It's my fault.
That's the line again.
Today we have some special helpers, our Huggabear friends, Kensley and Ronan. And I forgot.
Thank you so much for letting me show you the new forest. Close.
Yeah.
Welcome back, sir. It's good to have you.
Oh, well, thank you, Buxley. It's good to be home.
Will you be needing anything else?
No, I think I'm quite good. I'm rather tired. I think I'll have...
Huggabear Friends is a LaFon-Cox family production.
Ta-da! Ta-da!